Hello everyone and good afternoon, I'm Hayden Banzel and you're watching the Tidewater Summer League YouTube channel. This is the second of third consecutive matchups set to take place here at Lakewood Park between the Greenbrier Knights and Norfolk Redbirds. The Knights were the home team on the previous matchup Thursday afternoon and they are donning their all-white home jerseys today. The Redbirds are in their road gray jerseys. Redbirds won the first game of the season between the two teams 6-4 back on Thursday, and that was thanks to an early start. They scored four runs in the first inning after four of their first five batters all got base hits to settle them into a 4-0 lead in the first. And the starting pitchers for today, Jacob Reganey, he's been the best pitcher by far for the Redbirds. He's going to start with the ball. He came into the ninth inning to complete the victory on Thursday against the Knights, and he'll be starting with the ball today. And for the Greenbrier Knights, Henry Suero is going to be starting for the second time this season. Both teams are 3-5 coming into PCL play, and there's a lot online today in the standings. Whoever falls in this matchup will drop to fifth place. And bearing the results in Edenton today between the Sea Dogs and the Steamers, the winner could be in a tie for third place. So we just had our home plate meeting between Chris Dodolo and Chuck Slaughter, and we're about to get set to start here from Lakewood Park. We'll be back right after this. And the starting lineups today for the Norfolk Redbirds. Leading off and playing center field, Bryce Jones. Wes Bonney is batting second, playing short. Aiden Feather over at third base. He'll be batting third. Zach Jarnowski doing the catching, and he'll be batting fourth. Batting fifth, playing first, Drew Proctor. Batting sixth and playing left is Alex Brown. Jason Boscher out in right, batting seventh. Jack Mork batting eighth, DHing. Sparky Bannon batting ninth, playing second. Brady Kenter is the extra hitter. He'll be batting 10th, and the second extra hitter for the Redbirds is Trevor Self, batting 11th for the Knights. Quincy Scipio will be leading off, playing center. Max Lucas batting second and playing second. Luke Waters, he'll be out in left, batting third. Warren Bailey doing the catching today. He'll be batting fourth. Andrea Daltrey over at third base, batting fifth. Andy Choi doing the DHing today. Blake Herman out in right field again. Tristan Hensley, the extra hitter, batting eighth. Dylan Bowen batting first, batting ninth, and playing first. And Tom Proctor batting 10th and playing shortstop. And we are ready to start here from Lakewood Park for the second straight matchup between these two teams. And it's a winning game here in Lakewood Park. And we're on the right. First pitch, a swing and a miss from Bryce Jones. Below the knee. nominee is from Suero, 1-1. And that pitch is popped up to center, and Scipio jogs in for it and waits for it and makes the catch. So the first out of the afternoon, we have 14 mile per hour winds here in Norfolk, Virginia. The second start of the season for Suera. His last one came back on June 19th. And that one's fouled back by West Bonney, 0-1. Suera's only start came in Tri-City against the Chili Peppers, allowed 3 runs, all that were earned. One to Bonney, and there's a good spot there from Suera, and it's 1-2. From Suera, and breaking ball that bounces in the dirt, and the count evens up at 2-2. One misses, and it's now a full count here on Bonney. Bonney has an OPS of 901 this season for Norfolk. And he shoots that one towards the left center gap, overcomes Waters, and it's over his head, and it bounces off of the wall. A one-out double from West Bonney, his fourth of the season. For the first hit of the afternoon. Mentioned in the pregame that the Redbirds first 5 batters in the first inning of the last matchup, as the Knights tried to pull off the hidden ball trick. Lucas had the ball in his hand and he got a kind gesture from Chris Dodolo over at third. Good job from Bonney, though, to be aware of where the ball was. This is the first time that Dodolo was managing against the Knights. He was not here on Thursday. So Jack Markey was named the head coach for that game. Scored in the first inning for the first game against the Redbirds, and one out, base runner over on second. And Feather is at the plate. And that one bounces in front of Bailey. He never saw where it went, though. And so Bonney will take third. To Feather, 2-2. Feather went around on a swing on the previous pitch that Bonney took third on. Yeah. 2-2 from Suera, and that one's hit towards the right side, and jumping to make the catch is Herman, tagging from third, and arriving safely is Bonney. So productive out there. happening yet again. Nice catch out there in right from Herman. Herman was busy in his last start in right field Wednesday against Edenton. It was a called strike on Jaranowski, nothing and one. Herman had four catches made out in right. And that one skied out towards the right side again. Lucas coming over, but Herman there again to make the catch as he drops his hat. But the Redbirds do tack on a run. It's 1-0 going to the bottom of the first. Get your game on with DBAT Virginia Beach baseball, softball, training, and more. DBAT Virginia Beach is a state-of-the-art facility with over 17,000 square feet, 13 batting cages, and professional instructors who don't just know baseball and softball, but live and breathe it. You can find them located at 5258A Fairfield Shopping Center in Virginia Beach. You can call them at 757-467-1111. You can also visit their website at dbatvirginiabeach.com. So the Redbirds tack on a run in the first inning. Quincy Cepillo leading off against Jacob Burgani. Burgani has just been a stud since he's come down. To the Tidewater Summer League, an ERA of 1.26. And Regani bounces that one in the dirt. Two-oh count here on Cepillo. And there's a called strike, 2-1. And the 2-1 is looped over towards the right side. That'll dunk in for a base hit for Cepillo. And the Knights have their leadoff hitter aboard. See what they decide to do here. Cepillo not running as Lucas fouls that one off. On 7 stolen base attempts this season from Quincy, he's arrived safely on all of them. 0-1 here, and Reganey checks in on Scipio. Slides back in safely. Check again. On Scipio. 0-1 count here on Lucas. And there goes Scipio, and the ball is in the dirt as Reganey tells Jarnowski, my bad. Lucas had a hit in his first 7 games. And now 0 for his last 7. And that one hits Lucas. So he'll go to first. Scipio is taking third just in case that was a pass ball, but it was indeed a dead ball. So the first 2 base runners aboard for the Knights. And that ball is upstairs to Waters, 1-0. And the 1-0 is shot out towards left. Waiting for it is Brown, and tagging Scipio. The throw to third is not in time. A good shootout there from Alex Brown out in left. So a productive first out as Waters moves Lucas to second and Scipio to third on the sack fly. Here is Warren Bailey. Warren behind the plate today, after DHing, and he shoots that one up the middle, a base hit. 1-1 will score. Lucas was held up, and it gets under the glove of Jones, and Lucas will come around to score. And Chris Dodolo is going to go out to have a talk with Jacob Reganey. That ball just went under the glove of Bryce Jones. Lucas was being held up at third. So Warren Bailey is credited with a double there. And that pitch is fired in for a strike to Daltrey, 0-1. And that one shot towards the right side. Bannon moves to his left, and that gets through him. Bailey rounding third. And he'll score without a throw as Boschard cuts it off to second. It was a good pitch there from Reganey. But a good job there from Daltrey to push it the other way. Still one down here in the first inning. Andy Choi takes that one up high, 1-0. Reganey had not allowed more than an earned run in any outing. And already three here with just one out recorded. So after the Redbirds woke up early in the first meeting, it's the Knights doing it this time with three runs already aboard here, and Choi takes a good cut at a fastball, 1-2. And that one's bounced, good stop there from Jarnowski. To have Daltrey stay on first. Two from Reganey to Choi. And a good leave there from Choi on the breaking ball. And the count is full. Pitch from Reganey to Choi. Daltrey running. And Choi lives to fight another pitch. Daltrey wasn't running on the first pitch of the full count and was going on the last one. Upstairs, it goes to the backstop. So an 8-pitch walk to Choi. Good AB there. And it brings up Blake Herman. Shoots that one to left field. That'll fall in front of Brown. A base hit. As the throw to third hits Daltrey. But he's fine. And now the bases are loaded with one down for Tristan Hensley. Nice first pitch hitting there from Blake Herman. A pitch that was middle in. For Tristan Hensley. And that one stopped by Jarnowski. And a good job there. This time is called. We have not seen Reganey struggle like this season. We'll see how he stops the bleeding here. He can use a ground ball. There is a ground ball, but it's shot foul. Big spot here for Hensley, still looking for his first RBI of the season with the corners playing in. And there's a good spot there from Reganey, and it's nothing and two. Drew Proctor in at first, with Aiden Feather in at third. Middle infield waiting for a double play ball as it's fouled off by Hensley. And we'll do the 0-2 again. O2 from Reganey, and Hensley lives to fight another pitch.
What'd I do?
Where's Michael?
In the van.
No balls, two strikes. Here's the pitch from Reganey to Hensley. Swing and a miss in the dirt, but it gets by Jarnowski, and a good hustle play from Daltrey, who had a great read on that ball. As time is called, as the home plate umpire will brush off home plate, where four night runs have come across the score. Even on the Hensley strikeout, it was a great job there from Daltrey to read that ball. Once it hit the dirt, he was going. And that spike, that time, Troy got a jump on it, throw to third. I believe the third base umpire said he was out. The Redbirds are coming in, but Feather didn't have the ball in his glove. And so now everyone's going to head back to their positions. Troy, like Daltrey, went right when the ball was skipped. But a good stop there from Jarnowski, and he almost had Choi gunned down at third. 2-0 was fouled straight back. Two-1 count. That one's in the dirt. Troy, much more lenient that time, as he's now being instructed by his third base coach, Jameson Griffin. Good hitter's count. See what Bowen can do. And it's a fly ball out towards center. Back goes Jones, and he makes the catch. But four runs come in to score for the inning for the Knights as they lead 4-1 at the end of one. Mercedes-Benz of Virginia Beach has earned a reputation as one of the Hampton Roads' most trusted luxury car dealers. Since their establishment in 2014, they found themselves as a premier name for Mercedes-Benz sales with exceptional service and unbeatable selections. If you're looking for a newer pre-owned Mercedes-Benz, they're the place to go to, being the premier dealership in Virginia Beach with a vast selection of Mercedes-Benz vehicles and easy leasing and financing. They're located on 4949 Virginia Beach Boulevard in Virginia Beach. Can be called at 757-499-3771. You can also visit their website at MercedesBenzOfVirginiaBeach.com. Lead put up a four spot for him in the first after allowing a run in the top half of the frame. A one count here on Drew Proctor. And Proctor swings at a pitch in the dirt, nothing and two. And a three pitch strikeout from Suera gets things started in the second. First strikeout for Suera. And it brings up Alex Brown. And he takes a called strike, nothing and one. Coming into the day in his 9 innings and 1/3 of work. As he bounces that one in the dirt to Brown, 2-1. Swing and a miss there from Brown. And the count is now even at 2-2. Brown hitting .250 this season. He's been very good at just putting the ball in play in the Tidewater Summer League. And he puts that one in play, but that one's off his toe. Six strikeouts and 22 plate appearances. Suera nods his head to Bailey and they're ready. From the windup, a bit of a different motion, and that one hit Brown. As he shakes his hand, Suera kind of held his left leg up in the air a bit longer than usual to try to throw off the timing of Brown on a 2-2 pitch, but just lost the release of the ball. Here's Jason Boscher, and Boscher chops that one to third. Going to be a tough play for Daltrey, and he won't get there. It's going to be a tough play regardless, even if he was able to scoop it up. A high chopping ball. So here's the designated hitter, Jack Mork. He takes that one upstairs, 1-0. Redbirds down by 3 runs in the top of the second. And there's a good spot there from Suera to even it up at 1-1. One, two count here on Morick. And Morick shoots that one out to left. Waters is under there. And he makes the catch. Brown thought about tagging, but it'll hold on a nice shoot to third from Waters. And that's the second out. So here's Sparky Bannon. Second baseman for the Redbirds. And Sparky fouls that one off. From Suera, nothing in one. And the L1 is fouled off of the mask of Bailey. And it's nothing in two. Oh, two? Got him looking, strike three. Got Bannon looking on the curveball. The Redbirds leave two runners stranded in the top of the second. It's 4-1, Greenbrier. Offers service and repairs so you have access to the latest specialized technology and precise analysis from Mercedes-Benz trained technicians who undergo regular and frequent training so they're always up to date on every component of your vehicle. Find them at 4949 Virginia Beach Boulevard in Virginia Beach. Call them at 757-499-3773 for their service and repair shop or visit their website at MercedesBenzOfVirginiaBeach.com. Dom Proctor leading off the second inning against Jacob Reganey. We'll see how Jacob bounces back. And first pitch that Proctor sees is fouled off. Reganey did leave two runners in scoring position in the first inning. And he bounces that one to Jarnowski, 1-1. See how he takes the second inning. And there's a letter high strike from Reganey, 1-2. And a hit over to third where Feather is. Moves to his left, throw in the dirt, gets pick up there from Proctor. For the first out of the home second. So back to the top of the order for the Knights. Scipio got things started with a leadoff single. Came around to score on Bailey's double last inning. So the first meeting between the teams, the Redbirds' first five hitters had four hits, scored four runs. And this time it's Greenbrier, whose first five batters had four hits and scored four runs. And there's a good pitch there from Reganey. That catches the inside corner, 2-1 the count. And Scipio fouls that one over to the right side. Two and two. And that curveball is shot out towards center. Going back now is Jones. And he makes the catch. Jones was coming in on that one originally and then had to backtrack a couple strides to his right. So two outs and nobody on for Max Lucas. And Lucas backs away from that pitch. Shoots that one, but foul. 2-2 count here on the two-hole hitter and second baseman, Max Lucas. Lucas fouls that one off. Lucas leads the team in hit-by pitches. He got hit three times on Saturday against one of the Richmond teams and already won here today. He's got four. It's a couple guys who have two. And that time Lucas hits a high fly ball. It should be playable. And it lands just in front of the right fielder, Boscher, in foul territory. Lucas trying to even out his swing here. And Reganey is told to step off as Boscher wasn't ready. In his position. 2-2 again. And Lucas goes down on strike. So a nice bounce back inning from Reganey. As he sets down the Greenbrier Knights. 1-2-3. We've played two innings from Lakewood Park. 4-1 Knights. Local business owners and community organizers, promote your business and events right here on the Tidewater Summer League YouTube channel. You have the opportunity to promote your business and events right here with your logo being featured on the screen. Please email TidewaterSummerLeague@gmail.com to promote your business or events today. Brady Kenter leading off the third inning for the Norfolk Redbirds. Left-handed batter, and he takes that one inside from Swear up 1-0. And Kenter, it's a ground ball over to Bowen, and he'll take it himself on a race to the bag. He beats out Kenter. the first out of the inning. So here's Trevor Self. Trevor, the extra hitter today for Chris Dodolo, as was Kenter. And he leaves that one below the knees for a ball, 1-0. And Self takes a cut at a high fastball. And it's 1-1. Suarez shakes off Bailey, and now they're ready. And there's a called strike. Good spot there from Suarez. 1-2. And time is called as Suarez trying to get on the same page as Bailey. Bailey's been flip-flopping between DHing and catching, so getting a lot of opportunity to play in the Tidewater Summer League. Getting his reps in. 2-2. Just below the knees. And the count is full. That's where it checks in. The home plate umpire on the count. And here's the delivery, and it's up high. Ball four. And did he go around first base? Umpire says he did not. So aboard with a walk is Trevor Self. Seventh walk drawn this season by Self. Back to the top of the Norfolk lineup. And Jones swings and misses at that. Pitch, nothing and one. Self leads the team in walks over on first. One count here. Here's the pitch, and that's fouled back. 1-2. Daltrey playing relatively in over at third. On the left-footed Jones. And Jones asks for time, doesn't get it. And the pitch is inside. Jones was calling for time from the home plate umpire, but he'll take the inside pitch to even the count at 2-2 with one down. Self over on first. Here's the delivery from Suarez, and it's in the third, and there goes Self. Throw down from Bailey, not in time. And it'll roll into center field. Self will stay at second. That ball bounced in the dirt. A good job by Bailey to keep it in front of him. Self was not stealing. He was going on the ball in the dirt. Now 3-2. And a called strike three. That ball just caught the corner. According to the home plate umpire, and there are two down. So here's Wes Bonney. Bonney hit a double into the left center gap in his first at bat, and he takes that one upstairs. 1-0. Suera. Bonney now leads the team in doubles after he had his fourth of the season in his last at bat, and now he has a 3-0 count. And Bonney draws a four-pitch walk. First walk, second walk of the inning from Suera after he didn't walk anyone in the first two innings. And that one's upstairs to Feather, 1-0. And there's a strike from Suera, 1-1. Henry has had four walks in his nine innings and one third. As that one shot out towards left, a base hit for Feather, and it'll load the bases. So another quality at bat for Aiden Feather, and it loads the bases with two out for Zach Jarnowski. Jarnowski flew out to right in his first at bat and takes a called strike there from Suera, 0-1. And now it's quickly 0-2. Hit Jarnowski, and it'll bring in a run. Second time that Jarnowski has been hit this season with the bases loaded. And that one was on an 0-2 pitch. So Bailey's going to go out to have a talk with Suera. Suera didn't allow any walks to his first two innings of work, but two here and a hit by pitch. on Drew Proctor. Already a run in for the inning for the Redbirds. And there's a good spot there from Suera after the conversation with Bailey. One, one. And no check from any of the field umpires. And called a ball, 2-1. And that one's fouled back by Proctor, 2-2. This would be a big spot to have your first hit of the season if you're Drew Proctor. And swing and a miss at a pitch in the dirt for strike three. So a run comes in to score for the Redbirds, but they leave the bases stranded. We'll go to the bottom of the third, 4-2, Greenbrier. Baseball, softball, training, and more. DBAT Virginia Beach is a state-of-the-art facility with over 17,000 square feet, 13 batting cages, and professional instructors who don't just know baseball and softball, but live and breathe it. You can find them located on 5258A. Call them at 757-467-1111. You can also visit their website at dbatvirginiabeach.com. Waters from Reganey, nothing and one. Yep. Reganey had a solid bounce back. That's out. Greenbrier 1-2-3. After allowing four runs in the first, the team tacked on another run for him in the top half of the inning as they try and claw back. Waters 0-for-1, did have a quality at bat though. Pitches. Back-to-back strikeouts from Reganey. And that's the first out of the third. Here's Warren Bailey. Was credited with a 2 RBI double and knocked in the first two Greenbrier ones. Warren takes a called strike there and nothing and one. Warren hit the ball out to center. That went under the glove of Jones. And he gets a piece of that one, and it's nothing and two. And Jarnowski just lost the ball. Oh, two from Reganey. Good leave there from Bailey. Good waist pitch. And it's 1-2. And that one's fouled off down the left field line. So we'll do the 1-2 again. And fouled down again. Same spot. Hit up the middle. Coming to his left is Bonnie. Throw to first is in time. Beautiful defensive play from Wes Bonnie. And also Drew Proctor, who stretched out as far as he could to retire Bailey, who was hustling down the first baseline. So Regani starting to find a groove here. That breaking pitch is inside to Daltrey. 1-0. Too well, Regani is working at a good pace here. And he fools Daltrey on that one. It was early on that. 2-1. And that one's bounced in front of home plate. Got a piece of it with Daltrey, and now the count is full. Three-two delivery. Shot out towards left. Brown is there, and he puts his hands up. It's off of the base of the wall. The third base umpire is coming out to have a look at the ball. Brown has his arms up. Daltrey is rounding the bases right now. And the umpire puts his two hands up, so it will be a double for Daltrey. As it got stuck under the fence. Here's Andy Choi now. So Daltrey's now 2-for-2 on the afternoon. First double of the season from Daltrey. One out here. And that one has popped up towards right center. Jones is there and he makes the catch. So another scoreless inning from Regani. We'll go to the fourth inning from Lakewood Park with the Knights up 4-2. 6, 7, 8 due up in the order for the Redbirds, and the first pitch from Suera in the first is up and into Brown, 1-0. And Suera fires in a strike, 1-1. Suera hit Brown in his first at bat. Brown is now tied for the team lead in hit by pitches with 3, along with Jack Mork, as he fouls that one off. Two-two. Looped over towards the right side. Could be playable for Bowen. And he can't make the over-the-shoulder grab. It was going to be a tough play regardless. So we'll do the 2-2 again. And Suera was starting his motion as time was called from Brown. 2-2 pitch. And that's popped straight up. Proctor is under it, and he makes the catch. Jason Boscher now steps in with one down. And nobody on in the top of the fourth. And Boscher leaves that one for a called strike at the letters, nothing and one. That one's just below the knees. Suera shakes off Bailey a couple times, now goes. And it's inside and off of the glove of Bailey. 2-1. And Boscher leaves that one for a ball, 3-1. Three-one from Suera to Boscher. And it's fouled off of the foot of Boscher, called immediately by the home plate umpire. What a nice effort there from Boscher to just hustle out of the box, never known till the call is made. Here's the 3-2. And that one's grounded over to short. Another play for Proctor. And the throw to first is in time. Two up and two down here in the top of the fourth from Suera. And it brings up Jack Morick. And he taps the first pitch over to second, where Lucas is. So a 1-2-3 inning from Suera in the top of the fourth. We'll go to the bottom of the inning with the Knights up 4-2. Dylan Blazer, the new arm on the mound for Chris Dolo's Redbirds. And the first pitch he throws to Herman is hit out to center, and making a leaping catch is Bryce Jones, who fell down after making the grab. So one pitch and one hard out, retired by Dylan Blazer. Nice piece of hitting there from Herman. Someone picks up again and takes the curveball outside to Hensler. So Reganey was settling in after a rough first inning. Goes three innings, recorded three strikeouts, five hits, all of which were in the first inning on the four runs. And that curveball bounces to the fence. Now that one will go to the fence again. So a four-pitch walk drawn by Hensley. And first pitch swinging to center again. Much easier play that time for Jones. And that's the second out. Here's Dom Proctor. Proctor rolled one over to third in his first at bat and takes a called strike there from Blazer, nothing and one. Blazer started a game in Edenton, but didn't fare well, so trying to see what he's got out of the pen. And pickoff move, and it goes by the first baseman, Proctor. And now trying to go to third is Hensley. And he'll arrive safely. So the first pickoff move that we saw from Blazer was a fast one, but just threw it away. And it cost him two bases. A 1-1 count here on Proctor with now a runner over on third with two down in the fourth. And Proctor leaves that one upstairs, 2-1. And the 2-1 is fouled back, 2-2. Two pitch, and that's up again. So the count is now full on Proctor. Here's a delivery from Blazer, and it's in there, a called strike three. So the Knights leave a runner stranded on third base. We've played four innings at Lakewood Park. It's Greenbrier 4, Norfolk 2. Kyle Andrazik, now on the mound for the Knights. This first pitch is outside. And Banning. Fifth relief from Andrazik. First three outings were scoreless. Last one allowed a couple of runs, but that was also in three innings of work. That one's upstairs. Chuck Slaughter puts Andrazik back into the bullpen. Trying to work on his game there. It didn't fare well as a starter. Starting in Edenton. And that one's hit over the glove of Daltrey and dumped into left field. And a leadoff single gets us started in the fifth off of the bat of Sparky Banning. So here's Brady Kenter. Brady led off the third inning and rolled one over to Bowen at first. And now he shows bunt. He misses, throw down to first. From Bailey is off of the glove of Bowen. Banning will hold up. Called strike on Kenter. Kenter was already running out of the box. Didn't get a piece of the ball. Kenter not showing bunt, swinging away, and that pitch is upstairs, 1-1. Banning gets signs from his manager at third base. Not going, and Kenter swings and misses. Banning hasn't attempted a stolen base this season, so I wouldn't expect him to be going here in a two-run ball game. Top half of the fifth. And there's a called strike three. First out recorded by Kyle Andrazik. That point continues to blow here at Lakewood Park. Walked and came around to score in the third inning. His only plate appearance, and now he pops that one over towards the right side. Lucas waits for it, makes the catch, and that'll be an inning-ending double play. Banning was running and just got caught up off guard. And so that'll be halfway through at Lakewood Park, 4-2, Knights. Dylan Blazer out there for his second inning of work, set to face the top of the night's lineup. And his first pitch to Sapia was in there for a called strike, nothing and one. Quincy's one for two today. Singled and came around to score in the first inning. And now he hits a fly ball towards center. And over comes Jones to make the catch. Second time that Scipio has flied out to center, and that's the first out of the bottom half of the fifth. And Lucas calls time as Blazer was about to pitch before Lucas was not even close to ready. Lucas 0 for 1. And he swings and misses at the breaking ball from Blazer, nothing and 1. That one's fired in for a strike, and it's nothing and 2. Oh, 2. And that one's bounced in the dirt. One ball, two strikes here on Lucas. Here's the pitch from Blazer, and that's outside, 2-2. Delivery, and that one's in the dirt. So after Lucas was down in the count 0-2, it's now full. Here's the pitch, and Lucas shoots that one towards the right side. That'll go through for a base hit. Solid piece of hitting there from Lucas. He shoots that one towards the right side in between the first and second baseman. So that snaps Max's streak of four games without a hit. I know Max was working, went to the cage yesterday on their off day to go get some reps in, and it pays off. And now he gets picked off, but Proctor couldn't scoop up the ball. It was a good move there from Blazer. Second time we've seen him have a good move, but not a good throw back to the bag, something that he's trying to work on down here. And he throws that one upstairs. Chris Doodle instructs his second baseman to back off of Lucas. With one down, and Waters hits a deep fly ball towards left. Back goes Brown to the warning track, and he makes the catch. Tagging and going to third is Lucas, but Alex Brown just took a home run away from Luke Waters. Unbelievable. Good idea there from Lucas to tag up on the ball that was hit by Waters. So he moves over to third. And there are now two down. And that one shot out towards right. Easier play for Boscher. And he makes the catch. At the end of five, it's the Knights 4, Redbirds 2 here at Lakewood Park. top of the order. Leading off here in the top of the sixth inning. And the first pitch in the sixth from Mandrazik is up high. 1-0. Jones 0-2 thus far today. And that one is at the letters. One. That one shot out towards center, and comes Scipio, and he'll let it bounce in front of him. Was a tough decision that Scipio had to make, whether he wanted to dive for that ball or let it bounce in front of him, and he goes the safe route rather than having that ball roll past him out in center. So a leadoff single in the sixth for Jones. Bunt is Wes Bonney, and Andrazik fires in a strike. Bonney not showing bunt right now. And he takes that one on the outside corner, 0-2. Two pitch, and it's fouled off by Bonney. We'll live to fight another pitch. Oh, 2 again. And that one hit Bonney. And so he'll walk over to first. Not what Andrazik was trying to do there on 0-2. And Aiden Feather is having a talk with his manager with two on and nobody out. Redbirds down by two runs here in the top of the sixth. So we'll see if they decide to bunt with Feather to move the tying runs into scoring position. Feather's back in the box, so most likely not, but he is showing bunt. And pitches a ball, 1-0. Typically, if you're bunting, you'd like to be all the way up in the front of the box because it gives you more room to hit the ball fair. So corners are in now for the Knights. Feather shows bunt and takes a called strike. Chris Dolo going to give his base runners and his hitter some more signs. 1-1 count here. Feather already had a productive out in the first inning. And now he's swinging and hits one over to third. Daltrey only plays to first as no one was on second.
They were wheeling to defend the bunt. Left second open.
The Knights had the wheel on, so no one was over to cover second base. So one out. And runners on second and third. So essentially does the same thing as a bunt would do. Except Feather just grounded it over to third. Here's Zach Jarnowski. Jarnowski had an RBI three on the season. Two of them have come with the bases loaded and him being hit by pitches. That one's called a ball. Could have been a strike, but Bailey couldn't squeeze it. So 3-0 count here. And that one's outside. It gets by Bailey. And here comes Jones to score. So a four-pitch walk to Jarnowski. And on the wild pitch, Jones comes in to score. And Jameson Griffin's gonna go out to have a talk with Kyle Andrazek. So runners on the corners with one down here. Already a run in the inning for the Redbirds. Jarnowski not running, and that one skied out towards the left side. Foul. Wes Overton is warming up in the Knights bullpen. Proctor swings through that one, and it's nothing and two. Big breath in from Proctor. Here's the 0-2 from Mandrazek, and it's grounded towards the left side. Throw to second is in time. Quality at bat from Drew Proctor. Second RBI of the season for Proctor. A nice job there from the other Proctor, Dominic, to make that play going to his right and get the force out at second. That one's hit foul by Brown down the left field line. From this angle, but called foul. So 0-1 here on Brown. Takes that one inside, 1-1, came inches away from an extra base hit.
I have the players work the field. Some of the teams are really good at it. Some still need work. Yeah. By the last game, by the last game of the summer, it'll be perfect. And then we'll all go.
1-1 count. And that's upstairs. Back pick, throw down from Bailey. And diving back in there safely is Proctor. Two one here on Brown, and he fouls that one straight back. Winds pick up here. Lakewood Park. Coming in at 14 miles an hour. We'll do the 2-2 again. From Andrezic to Brown. Swing and a miss. Strike three. For the third out. But the Redbirds tie the game. We'll go to the bottom of the sixth. Knot it up at 4 apiece. So the Redbirds put up a two spot to take Jacob Burgani off the hook, tie this game up at 4. Dylan Blazer out there for his third inning of work, so definitely has fared a lot better out of the bullpen. Two scoreless innings thus far, and that pitch is sent out to left by Daltrey, coming Brown! And diving, and he can't make the catch, and it'll roll all the way to the wall. And standing at second with the leadoff double is Andrea Daltrey, the second double of the day. He's now 3-for-3. So Daltrey's bat has woken up today at Lakewood Park. And now Sean Hahn is pinch hitting for Andy Choi, who was in the DH spot. A big at bat here from Hahn. And there's a called strike on Hahn, nothing and one. Big spot here for Hahn, looking for his first hit of the season. It would be a big one if he can put the Knights back on top here. And he hits that one towards the right side. Bannon is there, but a productive out there from Sean Hahn to move Daltrey over to third. With just one out. And here's the other Hahn, spelled differently, Burton Hahn. Sean's last name is spelled H-A-N. Burton's last name is H-A-H-N. Blake Herman. The two of them had a nice bond here since meeting each other in the Tidewater Summer League, making connections with each other. 1-0 is fouled off. This is Burton's first game since June 21st. That was here against the Steamers. Where he was taking some rest. And he hits a fly ball towards right. See if that's deep enough. Boscher makes the catch and Daltrey will hold up at third. So So a good idea there from Bertenhahn, but just couldn't get it deep enough to right. So now Nick Arnold getting his first game time today, pinch hitting for the extra hitter, Tristan Hensley. And that one hits Arnold on the first pitch. And he'll take first. So here's Dylan Bowen. Dylan's fly out to center. And his two at-bats today. Fouls off. Pitch from Blazer, nothing and one. Back his swing, it's 2-1. With Daltrey on third after he had a leadoff double, and Arnold on first after he was pinch hitting and got hit by the first pitch. And Blazer fires in a strike there to even up the count at 2 apiece. Two on, two out, 2-2 the count. Arnold's going, and the pitch is in the dirt. And no throw down from Jarnowski. Second stolen base of the season from Arnold. Three, two. Shot out towards left center again. Overcomes Brown, and he makes the catch. So the Knights leave two runners stranded in scoring position at the end of six. We're tied up at four. Wesley Overton now in the game and on the mound for the Knights. A big spot here, a tie game in the top of the seventh. Jason Boscher up at the dish, takes a called strike to even up the count at one apiece. Overton's gone three innings this season and eight earned runs. Being used here in a tie ball game. Here's the 1-2. And Boscher broke his bat, but he'll dump it into left field for a base hit. So a leadoff single from Boscher. That's his second single of the day. He's now 2-for-3. Singles against the Knights on Thursday. And there goes Boscher. Throw down from Bailey, not in time. First stolen base attempt of the season from Boscher. And the Redbirds have a runner in scoring position with nobody out. Bailey had Boscher with two strikes. Now Morick in an 0-2 hole. And a called strike three. That was Nick Jazakowski, who was pinch hitting for the DH Morick. And he goes down looking on three pitches. And Bannon pops up the first pitch from Overton, and Bowen dropped the ball. And now going to third, and now he's going to take home. So Boscher and Bannon trade spots on a pop-up. It's popped up towards the right side and fair ground for Bowen. Just fell in front of him. Boscher took third once it fell. And Bowen tried to nail him at third, but it went by Andrea Daltrey. To bring in a run, and now Bannon standing on second. Brady Kenter up at the plate. And he takes a cut of that fastball from Overton. 1-1. Kenter leaves that one outside of the strike zone. And it's 2-1. Kenter 0-for-2 today. Redbirds trailed 4-1 in this game. Kenter takes a hack at that pitch, and it's 2-2. Burton Hahn is out in right field after he pinched hit for Blake Herman in the last half inning. And Ronaldo Perez is at shortstop. Kenter hits a tapper. Overton comes to his left. His throw to first is in time. And Bowen will check in on Bannon, who moved to third on the throw. A nice play there from Wesley Overton. That looked like Kenter was going to beat it out the whole way. But Overton took his time, picked up the ball, and just was able to beat out Kenter. Who moves Bannon over to third. In a 5-4 ball game. And Overton spikes that pitch. But a good job from Bailey to keep it in front of him. Trevor Self, 0-for-1 today. He hit that pop up to Lucas, where Bannon was doubled off for. In a strike. If Self can reach, Alec Aguilar is in the on deck circle in place of Bryce Jones. And Overton fires another one across the dish. 2-2. That one caught the outside corner. Two count here. The pitch from Overton is hit towards the right side. In comes Hahn. That'll fall in front of him. It's an RBI single for Self. His first hit of the afternoon. And it puts the Redbirds on top 6-4 now. Alec Aguilar now pinch hitting for Bryce Jones. And Aguilar takes a called strike, nothing and one. Shoots that one, so right, that one should be playable for Hahn, who makes the catch. But two runs coming to score for the Redbirds as they take the lead 6-4. Stretch time here at Lakewood Park. Ronaldo Perez leading off the bottom of the seventh for the Knights. Perez came in defensively, and that first pitch hits Perez on the toe. So he confirms with the home plate umpire that he gets the take first, and he does. This is Devin Hicks' first pitch. He's now out on the mound. And now back to the top of the lineup for the Knights. For a ball, 1-0. New defense out there for the Redbirds. Alex Aguilar, who pinch-hitted in the top half of the inning, is now at short. Wes Bonney moves from short to right. Bosher from right to center. And Kenter is in at left. And Hicks checks in. And a close play over at first. But the first base umpire called Perez safe. A quick move there from Devin Hicks. Perez is now being instructed on what to do after he saw the first move from Hicks. And he'll throw it over again. That time not as close. Second time that Hicks is coming out of the bullpen. He fared well in his first outing. Went two scoreless innings. 1-0. In the dirt, and a back pick now on Perez. And the swipe tag, and he is gunned down. Perez. Took an extra lead after the ball was in the dirt. And Ben Adams, who came into the game for Jarnowski, threw down to first and easily got Perez. The throw beat Perez by so much that Proctor was waiting for the glove to just touched Perez as he was diving back. Now a 3-0 count, and it's a four-pitch walk drawn by Scipio. So after his first pitch hit Perez, four balls out of the zone, and Chris Dodal is going to have a word with Devin Hicks. Max Lucas now up at the plate. Max broke an 0-for-8 slump in his last at-bat with a single into right field. And there's the first pitch fired in from Hicks. Nothing and one. Scipio over at first in a two-run ball game. Hicks checks in on Scipio. He's back in safely. Still a little 1-6 to focus on Lucas, who he has in an 0-2 hole with one down here in the home seventh. 0-2, and Lucas hits a fly ball into center. That'll dunk in for a base hit. Scipio will stop at second. Aguilar was pretending that he was about to catch the ball. Held up Scipio a bit. And now there are runners on first and second with one down. So, Lucas, two consecutive hits. And there are runners on first and second for Luke Waters. Was robbed by Alex Brown in left field. And there's a wild pitch, and the tying runs will move into scoring position. So a big at bat here for Waters. And Luke leaves that one in the dirt as Adams pounces on top of that one. And it's 2-0. Luke had a huge game against the Redbirds on Thursday, 2-for-3. With a pair of doubles off of his college teammate, Vincent Bechara. And that one's in the dirt, and it's 3-0. Runners on second and third. Hicks having trouble finding the zone right now. And the 3-0 is upstairs.
Way to be patient.
The second four-pitch walk drawn by Knight's batters. And the bases are now loaded. So here's Warren Bailey. With the corners in for the Redbirds. And Bailey takes that ball for a ball 1-0. Ball was dropped by Adams as they were crossed up, him and Hicks. Adams pats Hicks on the back and walks back towards the mound. Bailey leads the Knights in home runs with 3. And Hicks gets a called strike there, 1-1. Scipio is on third. He walked. Waters on first, he walked. And Lucas on second, he singled. Here's the 1-1, and Bailey shoots that one foul, and it's 1-2. There's some action starting to heat up in the Redbird bullpen. And Bailey hits a ground ball to third. Feather is under it, and it goes right by him. One run will score. Here comes Lucas to tie up the game. So an error charge to Feather. And Bailey standing on second in what is now a tie ball game with Waters over on third. an error charge to Feather as Dom Proctor is now on second base as a courtesy runner for the catcher Bailey. Andrea Daltrey is already 3-for-3 today with 2 doubles. And that one thought it hit the bat of Daltrey, but it did hit him. This Chris Dolo thought it hit the bat too, but it hit the shin guard, or excuse me, arm elbow of Daltrey, and made a noise that sounded like the bat. So the bases are loaded again. On had a productive out in his last at bat that moved Daltrey from second to third after he doubled. And that one hit Hahn. The third hits batter of the inning. And it gives the Knights the lead. The first RBI since opening day for Hahn. And now it's Burt and Hahn. So from one Hahn to the other. And Burton fouls that one off of the foot of the home plate umpire. Already 3 runs in the inning for the Knights. They just have 1 hit though in the home 7th. And Hahn swings through that one as it gets by Adams. But Proctor will hold up at third. Proctor's on third, courtesy running for Bailey, who reached on an error. Daltrey at second, he got hit. And Sean Hahn at first, who was also hit. Now Burton Hahn in an 0-2 hole. And that one gets by Adams, but Proctor's gonna hold up. The other runners were already halfway onto the other bag. That pitch certainly looked like a strike too, but Adams didn't squeeze it and no call made. One-two pitch. And a good leave there from Hahn, and it evens up the count at 2 apiece. Hahn had an RBI in his last game. And he gets rung up as he has a smile as he walks back towards the dugout. That's the second out. And the first batter that Hicks has retired. Ronaldo Perez was picked off. He was the first batter of the inning. So here's Nick Arnold. Nick was hit by a pitch from Dylan Blazer on the first one he saw. And the first pitch, that time, is skied out towards right center. Overcomes Boscher. He won't get there. And it's off the base of the wall. 2 runs are in. Here comes Hahn. The throw to third is not in time. Nick Arnold with a bases clearing triple. And it's now 10-6, Greenbrier. That's the second time this season that Nick Arnold has had a bases clearing triple. And it extends the Knights' lead to 10-6. 2-0 count here on Dylan Bowen. And now it's 3-0. Bowen's 0 for 3. He's hit 3 fly balls to the outfield. And there's a called strike. One is in the dirt for ball four. And there are now runners on the corners for Ronaldo Perez, who led off this inning. Perez's was Hicks's first batter, and he hit him on the first pitch. And the first pitch that time fouled back. Nothing in one. Curveball there from Hicks, and he's up on the count 0-2 on Perez. Two, just fouled off, and Perez will stay alive to see another pitch. Two on, two out in an 0-2 hole here. Here's the pitch from Hicks, and it's in there for strike three. But not before 6 runs come in to score for the Knights, highlighted by a 3-run triple from Nick Arnold as they take the lead 10-6 at the end of 7. New arm on the mound for the Knights, and it's Blake Herman. Blake, who started in right today, making his second appearance on the mound, and he spikes the first pitch that he throws. 1-0. Knights put up 6 runs in the last half inning, so that actually puts Wesley Overton spot for a win today. 2-0 pitch is is up high to Bonnie, 3-0. 2, 3, and 4 in the order due up for Norfolk. Now trail 10-6. And a 4-pitch walk that starts Herman's afternoon. And it brings up Aiden Feather. So Herman finished off the ball game when he last pitched on June 18th. That was against the Patriots, the Piedmont Collegiate Baseball League. And that's 5 straight balls out of the zone for Herman. Herman went the last 4 innings of that game and had a beautiful play. Is in time! Beautiful throw down from Bailey to gun down Wes Bonney for the first out of the inning. And there's a strike from Herman. First time that Bonnie had been caught all season. Three-one, and that's fouled back by Feather, and the count is full. On that last play against the Patriots, they had a ground ball to the right side where Andrea Daltrey was playing first. As the 3-2 is rocketed out towards right center, overcomes Scipio. And that'll take one hop and go over the fence for a ground rule double from Aiden Feather. So Daltrey was over at first, got a ground ball at ate him up, but he was able to stay in front of it. Herman, who was running over to cover, got the ball and flipped it to Daltrey, who was standing on first. And the game was over as Herman was laying down, face down on his stomach. So here's Ben Adams. First pitch that he sees is chopped over to second. Lucas! A bobble and the throw to first is not in time. So an error going to be charged to Lucas. That ball was dying as it was rolling up to Lucas. But it was kept slowing down. Redbirds wanted a balk to be called. And the first pitch to Proctor is outside, 1-0. And this time Herman just throws to first to Adams, who's back in safely. And that makes that stolen base from Bonnie, where he was gunned down by Bailey, even bigger. That's the only out that's been recorded in the inning. 1-1 count here on Proctor. He's 0-for-3, does have an RBI on the fielder's choice in his last at bat, and he takes that one low from Herman. 2-1. Here's the 2-1 delivery to Proctor. And it's outside, 3-1. Oh, 3-1 from Herman. And it's shot out towards center. Should be playable for Scipio. Tagging at third is Feather. Scipio makes the catch. Here comes Feather, and he'll arrive safely without a throw. So a sack fly for Drew Proctor. That's his second RBI of the afternoon. And it makes it 10-7. That pitch misses from Herman, 1-0. Two outs, and Ben Adams, who did not tag on the sack fly, over at first. So Drew Proctor is still hitless on the season as Herman checks in on Adams, but has three RBI. So we'll see how long he can keep that up. Keep tacking on RBIs without getting any hits. 1-1. Swung through from Brown, and it's 1-2. And the 1-2 is grounded over towards the left side. Perez moving to his right. Throw to first is off the line, and it'll go to the Knights dugout. And taking third on the overthrow is Ben Adams. So the second error of the inning. From the Knights infield. On guys who typically you wouldn't see it from. Another shot towards the left side. This time Daltrey. His throw to first is off the bag. But a good job from Bowen to come off and slap the tag on Boscher. So the Redbirds tack on a run. We'll go to the bottom of the eighth. It's the Knights 10, Redbirds 7. New arm on the mound for the Redbirds, Bradshaw Morrison. Bradshaw got off to a rough start for Norfolk, but has had a couple weeks and under the management of Chris Dodolo, has worked on his craft and he's been a lot better. His last four innings have all been scoreless and trying to shut down the top of the night's batting order to keep the lead at three. In the bottom of the eighth inning here at Lakewood Park, here's the 1-0, and Scipio fouls it off, and it's 1-1. One count here. It's the pitch from Morrison. And that one shot out towards left. Kenter has room as he backtracks and makes the catch. Here's Max Lucas. Max now has two hits in his last two at-bats, so certainly getting his reps down here, and when he slumps, it pays off. He's reached base safely three times today. He's scored two of the 10 Greenbrier runs. And that 1-0 pitch is outside and away, 2-0. Lucas takes a called strike as he looks back at the home plate umpire, deemed that it just caught the corner of the inside of the plate. And Lucas fouls that one off, and Morrison evens up the count at two apiece. As Chris Dodolo throws over a new baseball to Ben Adams, overshot him. So here's a 2-2 count from Morrison to Lucas. And he lays off the breaking ball and the count is full. Following this game, as Lucas draws ball four, the Suffolk Voyagers will host the Tarboro River Bandits, scheduled to start about a half hour after the conclusion of this one, and we'll have it right here for you on the Tidewater Summer League YouTube channel. So Lucas is aboard for the fourth time today. And there goes Lucas, throw down from Adams, is not in time. So a called strike on Waters, nothing and one on him as Lucas takes second. And time is called as Adams is going to go out to have a talk with his pitcher Morrison. Waters is 0-3 today, does have a sack fly. He was robbed by Alex Brown of what looked like a home run. He did walk and score in the last inning. That was the third stolen base from Lucas this season. Oh, one pitch, and the breaking ball is outside. 1-1. And Waters swings and misses at that one. And it's 1-2. There goes Lucas again, and the pitch is grounded right in front of the mound by Waters, and he arrives safely with an infield single. That ball was just tapped by Waters. Put it right in the middle between Morrison and Adams. He's awarded with a hit. Sometimes that's just how baseball works. You barely hit the ball, you get a hit. You hit a rocket out to left field that goes as an out. Stealing on that pitch. Stands on third with Waters on first, and Morrison checks in on him. Warren Bailey hit that shot that went right through Aiden Feather at third. That two runs came in to score on, and now it's a high fly ball, but that one's fouled off. Bailey trying to even out his swing against Morrison with runners on the corners, one down here in the bottom of the eighth. And Bailey swings and misses at the breaking ball, one and two. And Morrison checks in on Waters again. A 1-2 count here on Bailey, who's yet to strike out this afternoon. And Morrison throws over again, and that one goes under the glove of Proctor, and in to score is Max Lucas from third. Time is called. Morrison checking in on Waters a little too much. Proctor just fortunate to knock it down with his glove. So Waters still over at first, and Bailey fouls off that pitch. Play today. No strikeouts. And he hits another ball in play towards right center. And that ball is caught by the diving Bosher. Had to come a long way in to get that one. To retire Bailey for the second out of the inning. So here's Daltrey. Daltrey was hit in his last at bat. He's 3-for-3 today. A pair of doubles and two runs scored, and again checking in on Waters. This season. That one's fouled off by Daltrey, nothing and one. And another throw over. That one gets by Proctor, but Waters will stay at first. Morrison has thrown over a lot for a base runner who's just got one stolen base. And there goes Waters, and the pitch is high. Throw down to second, not in time. And it'll roll into center field. So Luke Waters has his second stolen base of the season. As he stands on second, a 1-1 count here on Andrea Daltrey. Trying to stay hot, and that one spiked to Adams, and it's 2-1. Daltrey rips that one down the left field line. That's a fair ball. Waters will score. Daltrey's rounding first. He'll take second. The third double of the afternoon for Andrea Daltrey makes it 12-7 Greenbrier. Daltrey came into the day without a single double. Just one extra base hit. That was a home run. And now he's 4-for-4 today. So here's Sean Hahn. And Hahn hits a fly ball out towards left. In comes Kenter, he makes the catch. But two insurance runs score for the Knights as they tack on to their lead. It's 12-7 heading to the ninth. So Blake Herman back out there, small defensive substitution. Ronaldo Perez comes in to play second. As the wind continues to pick up here, and Dom Proctor back in at short. Nicholas Jazakowski is up at the plate as Herman throws that one away. Bat. 1-1 from Herman, and he fires that one in. 1-2. And Jazakowski hits that one towards the right side. A one hopper picked up nicely by Bowen for the first out of the ninth. Thank you. So here's Sparky Bannon. Bannon, one for three. He's singled. He's also reached on an error. Came around to score. And time is called. The 0-1 pitch is swung through from Bannon, and it's nothing and two. Oh, 2 from Herman. Struck him out. First strikeout from Herman. And the Redbirds are down to their final out of the afternoon. Brady Kenter, who's 0 for 3 today. Takes a ball high, 1-0. That pitch is low to Kenter, 2-0. And that one misses, and it's 3-0. Here's the 3-0 from Herman, and he fires in a strike. Trevor Self is on deck. And Kenter fouls it off, and Norfolk is down to their final strike. That one's hit right back to Herman. As he stares down, Kenter flips the ball to Bowen, and the ball game is over. The Knights take this one from the Redbirds, 12-7, for some revenge from Thursday. They improve to 8-5 overall, 4-5 in PCL play. They can now slide into a third place tie tonight, depending on the results from Virginia Beach and Edenton in their game down in Edenton. That's set for 7:00. We've got another game here, though. The Voyagers are hosting the Tarboro River Bandits. And that will be scheduled for about 7:15 here from Lakewood Park. It was a big day for Andrea Daltrey. He went 4-for-4 with 3 doubles. Nick Arnold had a big triple, too, that cleared the bases to improve the Knights to 4-5 in PCL play. Thank you for watching, everyone. I'm Hayden Bandel, and you're watching the Tidewater Summer League YouTube channel. Be stay to tuned in for our second game of our doubleheader.